Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to New Hope Volcano. This, you probably already know, is the last Sunday of 2020. So make it a good one, all of you who are here in person and all of you who are tuning in on Zoom. We're going to ask Pastor Moku to open us up with a word of prayer. If you would, please, Pastor Moku.
Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this new day. And we thank you, Father, that we are here before you this morning. What a joyous thing to know that, as you say it in your word, on earth as in heaven, and we are here in your house, in thy heavenly place on earth. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you for the words that will come forth this morning for our knowing, for our heavenly lives that we live here on earth. And we thank you, Lord, for this gathering with our family, the family of the God who is above all. We ask you for your blessings, your guiding, your covering on those who are still on their way. Bring them here safely. And we thank you, Lord, for this divine blessing. In the most righteous name of Christ Jesus, our Lord and King, we pray. And all of your children say,
Amen. We're going to sing this first song, and the words say, or the name of the song is Love You So Much. But before I start, I just wanted to recognize, you know, sometimes before you show up at service, there's some of us that show up at service to open doors and different things. And there are two wives that show up. One is my wife, Lonnie, and the other one is Kea's wife, Chris. And Proverbs 18 says, the man who has a wife, a good wife, has himself a good thing and will be blessed. So thank you, Miss Thing, Chris and Lonnie. I don't know if you should call him Miss Thing, but anyway. Just if you get in trouble, just say that's what Jason Morton told you to do, and then you'll be all right, okay? Let's sing to the Lord. Here we go. Hear these praises from a grateful heart. Each time I think of you, the praises start. Love you so much, Jesus. Love you so much. Lord, I love you when my soul sings. Here in your presence, carried on your wings. Love you so much. Jesus, love you so much.
How my soul.
How my soul longs for you, longs to worship you forever in your power and majesty.
Your power and majesty.
His praises from a grateful heart. Each time I think of you, the praises start. Love you so much, Jesus, love you so much.
Sing, Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you, and my soul sings. Hearing your presence carried on your wings. Love you so much, Jesus, love you so much.
Just that last part, love you so much.
Love you so much, Jesus, love you so much.
And one more time, just to the Lord.
Love you so much, Jesus, love you so much.
Let's applaud the name of Jesus. He's good.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. These are the days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sore. The way of the Lord. Behold, He comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, and trumpets all lift your voice. Clearly, out of Zion till salvation comes.
Sing about Ezekiel. Here we go.
These are the days of Ezekiel. The tribe will be coming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest. A field are as wide as the world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, preparing the way of the Lord. Behold, He comes. Shining like the sun, at the trumpet's call, so lift your voice, the year of Jubilee, out of Zion till salvation comes.
Now everybody sing, there's no God.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Yeah.
There's no God like Jehovah. 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 There's no God. Behold, He comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice, fear of jubilee.
Okay, here's one. favorite ones. We're not going to get let 2020 get away without us singing this song. One more time. Here we go.
I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. He called me friend.
Sing it again.
I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. He called me friend.
Who am I?
Who am I that you are mindful of me? That you hear me when I call. Is it true that you are thinking of me? How you love me? It's amazing, so amazing, so amazing. I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. He calls me friend.
Father God, we are so blessed to be here in corporate worship. Lord, we just thank you for our lives, for the bounty that you pour out on us. Lord, we are ever grateful. Thank you for family, for our church family, for friends that have gathered at this time. Lord, we ask for your protection, and we ask for healing for this land and healing for those who are sick. We just praise you, Lord, and ask you to bless every heart that is here today. Bless them through their week, that they may have success and that they may carry the message of your love to those who are lost. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen and amen. Let's just sing to the Lord. Sing now. Here you go.
Lord, I come to you. Let my heart be changed. Renewed, flowing from the grace that I found in you. And Lord, I come to know the weaknesses I see in me will be stripped away by the power of your love.
Everybody, let's sing that verse again. Sing to the Lord that verse again. Lord, I come to you. Sing.
Lord, I come to you.
Thank you, Lord.
Let my heart be changed.
That's our prayer.
Renew, flowing from the grace.
It's all you, Lord.
That I found in you.
No place else, only you, Lord God. And Lord, I've come.
And Lord, I've come to know.
Thank you, Lord.
The weaknesses I see in me will be stripped away by the power of your love.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Spirit leads me on in the power of your love.
Sing that chorus again. Hold me close. Sing to the Lord.
Hold me close
and
let your love surround me. Bring me near. Draw me. Spirit leads me on in the power of your love. Lord, unveil my eyes. Let me see you face to face. The knowledge of your love as you live.
With your presence, that you would continue to bless us. Thank you, Lord. This is one of my favorite songs. Very simple, two-line song, very simple words. And it says like this:
All hail King Jesus. Jesus, all hail Emmanuel, King of kings, Lord of lords, bright morning star. And throughout eternity, I am going to praise him, and I'll reign with him throughout eternity.
Sing again to the Lord.
All hail King Jesus, all
times, and I'll reign with him,
and I'll reign with him through all eternity.
One more, and I'll reign,
and I'll reign with him through all eternity. I sing praises to your name. Oh Lord, praises to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. I sing praises to your name. Oh Lord, praises to your name. And greatly to be praised.
Sing that once more. I sing praises.
I sing praises to your name. Oh Lord, praises to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. I sing praises to your name. Oh Lord, praises to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised.
Sing, for your name is great.
For your name is great. Greatly to be praised.
Last one, for your name is great.
For your name is great. And greatly to be praised.
Oh, we raise a hallelujah to you, Lord. About this in our message today, boldness and confidence and taking advantage of opportunities that the Lord may present to ourselves. So let's sing this. Here we go. Everybody.
Be bold, be strong. The Lord thy God is with thee. Be bold, be strong. The Lord thy God is with thee. Do not be afraid. Be dismayed. We're walking in faith and victory. Walking in faith and victory. Walking in faith and victory. For the Lord thy God. for the Lord, thy God is with
thee. We're going to run. Here we go.
We're going to run to the camp. Tell all the people, get ready. Get ready. We're going to run to the camp. Tell all the people, get ready. Get ready. Are you ready to take this land?
Are you ready to take this land?
Are you ready to take this land for the Lord? Be bold, be strong. The Lord our God is with thee. Be bold, be strong. The Lord our God is with thee. Do not be afraid. Walking in faith and victory. We're walking in faith and victory. We're walking in faith and victory. For the Lord, thy God is with.
For the Lord.
For the Lord, thy God is with.
For the Lord.
For the Lord, thy God is with.
Ladies and gentlemen, you can take the next few minutes, go greet somebody with the love of the Lord. That's the last time you get to do it in 2020. You can walk outside. You can do whatever you want for the next few minutes before we get started again. Beep.
For the next week, I think I ate so much. It was such a blessing, such a blessing. So thank you all for that. We've got a few announcements for you this morning. I did want to call up Chris to make her announcements this morning first, if that's okay. Thank you, Chris.
Oh, I just got the Zoomers muted a second ago. He asked me for the thumbs up, and I was, oh, for that. Okay. But I think we're all good. Let's see. Celebrate Recovery. On Friday, January 1st, on Zoom, and on Friday, January 8th, here in person. Masked and socially distanced. No food will be served. David, is it going to be 6 o'clock? 6 o'clock. Okay, so we'd love to see you on Zoom, but we'd love to see you here too. 6 o'clock, there's a whole group, and then there's a men's group and a women's group. And, you know, I think I say this every week, but if you haven't been there, you don't know what you're missing. So just try and show up. It'll be great to see you. Women's group is going to start January 31st. On Zoom, and Stacy's been given announcements about that every week. Is she gonna do another one today? I got it. Okay. We are going to be doing the books of Genesis and Exodus on the 31st. Same thing like I say for Celebrate Recovery. Come and check it out. Okay. Bible study on Wednesdays at 4 o'clock. Jason can tell you some more about that. Men's ministry, third Saturday in January 2021. It's coming. I think that's everything. NewHopeVolcano.com, a great way to share information. I put our Christmas service on the New Hope Volcano Facebook page, and with only 3 people sharing, it reached 300 people. So imagine what would happen if you shared it on your Facebook. Then more people and more people and more people. And we put the Zoom link on there too, so they can just pop on. And guess what? They have been. Woohoo!
Praise God. Thank you so much, Chris. Thank you so much for all that you do. So a few more announcements. The big one is this Thursday, if you guys want to write it down, put it in your calendars, 5 o'clock, we are going to have our annual prayer meeting, but we're going to do it on Zoom this year. Normally, we come in, we sit down, We pray together. We pray over each and every seat that's here. We pray over each and every person. We do that before the new year. And so this year, we're going to do it at 5 p.m. It's going to be on Zoom. I will send out an email, and I'll send out the link. It'll be the link we use for our Wednesday night Bible study and our men's ministry. So at 5 p.m. on Thursday, we'll have our annual prayer meeting. And speaking of prayers, you know, every week we try to ask if anyone is in need of prayer. We have some amazing, awesome prayer warriors that are ready to pray for you for whatever it is. Pray for yourselves, your family members. Just let your prayers be known. You know, you can let myself know, one of the elders know, anyone know, and then we'll forward it to the prayer warriors that pray every single week. So please put your requests forward. Also, like we used to say before, you can even write it down on a piece of paper. We used to have tear outs, but you can write it down on the back of your notes if you have room and drop it into the offering bowl. You know, if you have a prayer request, drop it into the offering bowl and we'll get it to the prayer warriors. And then just to follow up with what Chris said, Wednesday, 4 p.m., we've got our Bible studies. We've been doing it now for about 7 or 8 months. It's been pretty awesome. We've been connecting on Zoom there. So if you're interested, you can go to the website, click on Zoom meetings, and then all of the links to all of our meetings are there. So if you want to join us Wednesday at 4, the links are there on the website. Also, men's ministry, third Saturday. I think we're going to be meeting here as well in January. So I'll keep you guys up to date on that, all you men out there. And then the website, like Chris said, is awesome. But also, the other thing, I've shared this with you guys a couple of times, we have a YouTube channel. And so I was able to check out the Christmas service on YouTube. And so if I think most of us already have it on our phone, but you just open up YouTube. You open up YouTube and you type in New Hope Volcano. That's all you need to do is type in New Hope Volcano. And all of the messages are there. And so if you miss a message or if you want to share a message with a family member or friend, you can just go to YouTube, click on the message you want to hear. And below the message, there's a share button. And you can forward that to their email or to their text message. And that's the new way to share the message from New Hope Volcano. So again, the website, you can check it out. You can give your tithe or your offering there. And you can give your tithe and your offering here as well this morning into the offering bowl. It's on the back table if you want to drop it off that way. I think that's it for announcements. So we are going to pray over the tithes and offerings. And so if you could join me in bowing our heads and pray this morning. Father God, we come before you, Father, and we just lift up our thankful hearts to you, Father God. We thank you for the sun and the rain, Father God. We thank you for another day of life that you have blessed us with, Father. We thank you for caring for us and knowing our needs before we ask, Father God. This morning, we just want to lift our tithes and our offerings up to you in obedience to your word, Father God. We pray that you multiply it in abundance and use it according to your will. Father, we just want to lift Pastor Ray up to you this morning as he's about to share the message that comes from you for us, Father God. We pray for revelation knowledge that whatever you want to make known this morning, you make it known to us, Father God. We pray that your spirit flows freely here this morning. We thank you for your presence in this church. We thank you for our church family. We love you, Lord. We thank you and we pray in Christ Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen.
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 Let's give Jason a round of applause. Jason, you're doing a great job. I want to lend my voice to what he said about the prayer group that meets on Monday. You know, there's a song. I think I sang it when I was in Sunday school, but it's a long time ago, so I can't remember. And it said, it's me, it's me, it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Not my brother, not my sister, but it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Everybody needs prayer. Everybody could use more prayer, even if you don't have a specific thing, then that's all right. Then just share that as a praise report. You know, the prayer team, I know I'm not speaking out of turn, but the prayer team loves to hear praise reports. It's quite common that they get a request, but then they don't hear you know, the resolution sometimes. And the resolution might have been miraculous. Great things might have happened. Healing might have occurred. Restoration might have occurred. But sometimes those praise reports don't get back to the prayer team. So just be reminded that you can share prayer requests, praise reports, everything. If you're sitting in the room and you want notes, there are some spread out on the chairs or out on the lanai on the tables. If you're watching by Zoom, we want to thank you all for continuing to use this method that the Lord has provided so that you can participate in the service remotely. There is always, Chris always is sure to put the notes, the songs, the lyrics, those things up on the website. So if you have them downloaded, then you're all set to go. We're going to start a new series of messages this morning, and it's called It's Still Christmas Time, because sometimes after the 25th of December, we somehow in our minds adjust so that, okay, Christmas is finished. Now we're on to something else. So this message, this series is entitled, It's Still Christmas Time. And the whole premise is there are certain things that we can do all year long, but somehow we pigeonhole them into certain times of the year. And Christmas is one of those where we think this is the season where we will do these things, or this is the season where we'll speak these words or do these different things. Now, I highlighted three or four of them that I think we, without any shadow of a doubt, we could stretch them to go all throughout the year. Because if you are like me, about this time of year, you start reflecting, oh, well, I should have done this, and I could have done that, and I had planned to do this, but I never really got around to it, and I wanted to talk to my neighbor, my friend, my relative, but I never really got around to it. So I felt like, well, if that's the case, if you are like me, I hope you are, I think you are, if you are like me and there are some of those things that appear, why not start right now? Then you got over 360 some days, you got a whole year to address some of those things. And this is what the whole series of messages will be about. So for example, Christmas time, Jason already said it, lots of people, I mean, they are overwhelmed by generosity, the generosity of other people, the generosity of their friends, the attitude that comes. Why not have that be a pervasive thing and carry out all throughout the year? So the whole goal in the series is to specifically identify some of those things, the greatest things about Christmas, and then strategize how we can deploy all of those things throughout the whole of 2021, so that 2021 will be the best year ever. Everybody please say the best year ever. Ready, go. The best year ever, 2021. The message this morning is entitled Time to Share the Good News. Now, sharing the good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ, is a choice that we get to make, and we might even get to make it several times a day. So it's not relegated to one time a day and then that's it, you hit your limit. You might even have opportunity to share the good news several times a day. After Christmas, Christmas trees are going to go away. I hope ours stay for a little while, because we had some great pictures standing in front of the trees, but then somehow we lost them. So we're going to take our Christmas pictures again. You'll see it on the 2021 Christmas card. It'll be these decorations. But after the 25th, pretty soon you start to see things happen. Okay, so the Christmas trees start to go away. The decorations start to go away. All of the sales at the store start to go away. Everything goes away. You don't give me any cookies anymore because Christmas has already gone away. I don't get any more fudge because Christmas has gone away. All kinds of things go away. But the good news of Jesus Christ never goes away. That's something that does not is not a stamp with a time stamp. That is relevant any time of day, any time of year, and it will never, never go away. One of the best things about telling somebody the good news of Christ is you get to tell it in your own way. So I get to tell it in my own way. Jason can tell it in his own way. Everybody gets to tell it in their own very specific way. You get to tell it with your personality and your particular gifting and your own words in your own way. Everybody gets to do it. That's one of the marvelous things about the gospel. And that should bring great joy. If it doesn't bring great joy, we need to reevaluate. Because every time you read the Christmas story, I read to you many verses, not all of them, but many of them that dealt with Christ's birth, the good news of Christ. And everything was always summarized with great joy. When people found out about it, they had great joy. When they shared it, they had great joy. They went and they endured all kinds of different obstacles so that they could behold this miraculous event and then go and tell somebody about it. It was like that at the first Christmas. Look at Luke in chapter 2. I begin reading to you from verse number 10. An angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. Don't get all shook up. I bring you good news of great what? Joy that will be for all the people." So the shepherds went out. They heard this. They went out. They checked this out. They wanted to know about the baby Jesus in Bethlehem. After that happened, this is Luke now, chapter 2 and verse 17. When they had seen him, the shepherds, they spread the word concerning what they had been told about this child. That's what the good news is all about. Someone told them, they then subsequently checked it out, and then they subsequently told somebody about what they had seen. Now, I talk to a lot of people, maybe because of I'm a vocational pastor, maybe more people, I'm not really sure, but I talk to a lot of people, you talk to a lot of people. A lot of people, when I talk about this particular subject, almost all of them want to share the good news. I meet very, very few people that will say to me, actually articulate, that they don't want to share the good news of Christ. Almost nobody will say that. Almost everybody, pretty exclusively, will say, I want to share the good news of Jesus Christ. I embrace that. That's all great. After all, I think to myself, well, who wouldn't want to share the good news? Almost everybody does. So then I thought, if that's the case, if everybody, almost everybody that I meet says, I want to share the good news. I want to share it with my family. I want to share it with my coworkers. I want to share the good news. If that's the case, then what gets in the way? Because they will say to me, I haven't done a very good job in sharing the good news. And if that's the case, they are self-admitting that they didn't do a good job. What is it that gets in the way? I'm in that category too. What stops us? If we know we want to share the good news, what is it that stops us? And we want to try to identify those things so that we can be more effective. Now, once we identify them, once we know what those things are that stop us from being as effective as we want to be, how do we get started? How do we get started now? Almost 1 year to go till 2021 Christmas. How do we get started in sharing this great news? Now, I want to share with you four things this morning that you and I can do. First, if you want to tell the good news, I must, and you can fill it in this way, enjoy the good news myself. Because we already, I think, will agree, it's going to be very difficult to tell somebody about the good news if you're not enjoying the good news yourself. And so that's where we want to start. Remember when we opened the message just a few moments ago, there was a scripture verse, and it said, when the angel said to the shepherds, I bring you good news of great joy. Now, when we linger on that for a moment, let that sink in. There's a question that will arise, I believe. How does the good news that the angel spoke about, how does that good news become great joy? The angel said, I bring you good news of great joy. So the question is, how does the good news become great joy? Here's the answer. Good news becomes great joy when it becomes personal, when it becomes something that is happening in my life, in your life, that's when the good news becomes great joy. Because otherwise, the good news is only information. If nothing has happened in your life in the personal sense, if nothing in your personality has changed, then it's all information. The good news is only information. I propose to you that it only becomes great joy when things begin to happen in your life. That the good news causes change, causes metamorphosis in your life. Then it becomes great joy when things are happening. If I read the newspaper about somebody who received, for example, I open up my news feed and I see somebody in, you know, Hilo that received an unexpected $20,000 check in the mail. It was caught him totally by surprise. He received this check and it was $20,000. That's good news for that person. That's not necessarily any good news for me. But that's good news for that person. But if I go to my post office box, if I put in my key and turn it, if I bring out an envelope, if I open that envelope, if I got a $20,000 check in my post office, then that's good news, and it's bringing me great joy without a shadow of a doubt. It's great news, bringing great joy for me. Now, why? Because it's personal. And I would propose to you that each one of us, if we've had an encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ, if we've embraced and received his salvation, if we live with the assurance that we'll spend all eternity with him, that should bring us great joy. And we have an opportunity because each one of us has a different personality, has a different vocabulary, has a different sphere of influence. We are blessed because the good news is personal. When the good news of Jesus Christ has come into this world becomes personal, it now is going to bring great joy. Psalm 107, I read to you from verse number 2. All of you set free by God, tell the good news. Right now, the band should be playing. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hill. Go tell it. That's what the Bible would say. It says it here and many other places. All of you who have been set free by God, tell the good news. Now, first, we got to realize that you have been set free by God because of that occurrence. Excuse me. I can go and tell the good news. If you're going to tell the good news to others, then you have to not only accept the good news into your life, but you have to be enjoying the good news. You have to be enjoying, for example, You've received the good news of forgiveness. You got to be enjoying that. You've received the good news of direction so that you don't have to make all your decisions by yourself because the Lord is helping you. You got to be enjoying that. You got to be enjoying the good news of camaraderie, that there is a certain a flavor to the fellowship that you have with other believers. That wasn't present before you knew the Lord, before you received salvation. That kind of camaraderie, that kind of friendship was not available to you. And you're living it now. You know the difference between now and then. And you got to be enjoying all of these things on a daily basis. Philippians chapter 4 is a fantastic scripture verse. In verse number 4, we read, "Be full of Lord in full of joy in the Lord always." Philippians chapter 4, verse 4. Be full of joy in the Lord all the time. And then that verse is, and I've told you this here before, in different messages, if the Bible says, and I say it again, that's the Bible's way of emphasizing the message that they're trying to get us to understand. And that's exactly what happens here. It says, I say it again, be full of joy. Be full of joy. Just spend some time with Jesus and you're going to be full of joy. And then Psalm 107, this is verse 22, says, with joy they should tell what he has done. Enjoy the relationship yourself. That's first. Second, I must, and you can fill it in this way, make the time. I have to make the time to tell the good news. Galatians chapter 4. But when the right time came, God sent his son born of a woman. God sent Jesus into this world at exactly the right time. Not too soon, not too late, but exactly at the right time. But oftentimes, we, myself included, we cannot seem to find the time to tell people the good news of Christ because we're too busy. We got too many things that we have to do. We have too many responsibilities. We have too many commitments. I'm not saying any of those commitments are out of order, bad, anything like that. But the fact of the matter is much of the problem that we encounter is because we are busy. That's why there's no time to share the good news with anybody. I know a lot of people who are enjoying the good news, enjoying salvation, enjoying forgiveness, enjoying direction, but they rarely take the time to tell anybody else, if ever. So it's rare, if ever, they tell the news to somebody else. So to that, Jesus says in the New Testament book of Matthew chapter 11, come to me, all of you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He's saying, I'm going to go through and help you purge, readjust, reassess your schedule so that you're not too weary, you're not overburdened. I'm going to help you. Come to me, if you're too busy, you're too stressed out, no more time to talk to anybody else, come to me. It's interesting to me that in December especially, we get everything except rest. We get cookies, no rest. We get fudge, no rest. We get gifts, no rest. This verse says, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and Jesus is speaking in here, I will give you rest. Now, that's just my observation. Maybe during December, you got plenty of rest. If that's the case, God bless you. You are really within the will of God because he wants his children to have their proper rest. I said this a couple of messages ago, and I was very blessed because I called for somebody in the congregation, and I was told, oh, they listened to your message and they're resting, so call back later. That's good. I like that. Remember, in that message, I told you, you ought to get your rest. That was only point number two. So if you wanted to go home, that's it. Go home. I'll finish the message here by myself, but the rest of you could go home because you needed, that was God, what God wanted you to hear was get some rest. Psalm 90, verse number two. Teach us to number our days and recognize how few they are. That means value the time that the Lord gives you. Help us to spend them as we should. That's Him going to Him wanting to direct us. So you don't have to do exactly what you did next Christmas as you did this Christmas 2 days ago. You don't have to do that. You don't have to replay Christmas 2020 in Christmas 2021. You can do something different if that's what you so choose. You have a year and the freedom to change. You can change your schedule. You can change it so that you have time to enjoy some of the relationships that you have. You can free yourself up to make the calls that you might not have had time to do this year, to write the cards that you wanted to write, plan to write, but didn't write. Time to share the good news. Enjoy the joy that you feel with other people. Which brings us to this. If we're going to share the good news, I have to, and this is number three, I must plan to do it. The truth is, every once in a while, we trip into doing something good, some good thing in life. I'm going to say that again. Every once in a while, we stumble into doing a good thing in life. But 90%, maybe more of the time, I guess, when we do a good thing, it's because somebody planned to do the good thing. So, for example, I'll just go off the top of my head. It's a good thing if we would serve some meals at Thanksgiving to people. That didn't happen without people planning. People planning to do it, people planning to participate, people giving to it. It didn't happen without planning. I think it was a good thing that we would be able to meet together to celebrate Christmas on Christmas Day. That didn't happen without planning. I think it's a good thing that because we live now in the COVID-19 era, it will be good that we would be able to communicate with congregation members via some other method besides meeting in person, because we knew that for some that's going to present a problem. Well, so then that didn't happen without planning. Almost every good thing that you would want to do had to be planned in advance. Now that's what happened at the very first Christmas. Luke chapter 2, verse 15. When angels had left them. So you remember, they've announced the good news of great joy. When the angels had left the shepherds, that's when this verse takes place, and gone into heaven, that's the angels, the shepherds said to one another, listen carefully, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, with which the Lord has told us about. Now, I share that verse with you to say this. That is a plan. Make no mistake about it. When the shepherds say, let's go, that's a plan. Because they could have just sat there. The angel spoke to them. They could have just sat there and said, whoa, dude, angels. Have angels ever appeared like that? And the other shepherd said, no, that's it. They could have done that, but they didn't do that. Somebody said, let's go. And somebody said, Let's go to Bethlehem. If that's where this thing is happening, let's go to Bethlehem. Somebody made a plan. With those shepherds, somebody made a plan. And again, I say, as a contrast, what if nobody had made a plan? What if the angels came, made this tremendous, miraculous proclamation? They come and they said what they said. They said this announcement, and all the shepherds did was sit there and say, wow, that's cool. And nothing. Where is the sheep? Look at more sheep. Where's the sheep? Are we going to do anything? Nah. Let's just sit here. Hey, but when those angels came, but the lights, whoo, fantastic. That's fantastic. Are we going to do anything about it? Nah. Let's just feed the sheep. The sheep might be hungry. Let's just feed them. What if they had done that? If you see the Christmas story, you know what would have happened. They would have missed the whole event. They would have missed the whole blessing. They would have been excluded from this very exclusive group. The baby in the manger and all of those things they would never have seen with their own eyes. But they made a simple plan. Let's go to Bethlehem. And because they went, they saw him. They beheld the baby Jesus. God tells them to make a plan. And he tells us to make a plan too. The Bible says in Mark chapter 16, Jesus said to his followers, this is verse 15, go everywhere in the world and tell the good news to everyone. Everywhere in the world. And you and I get to assign what everywhere in the world means. So if you want to come up with, you know, an international definition, you certainly may do that. You should do that. So, you know, if we support the missionaries who have come to do our Seder dinner, great. They're ministering in Israel. You know people who are ministering in all over Europe. You know people who have ministered in the Middle East. Our friend who just went home to be with the Lord, Hal Jones, ministered all over the world. You can do that. But don't let the definition be confined to those parameters. I mean, if this says go in everywhere in the world, that really could be Wainaku, that's everywhere in the world. Opihikau, plenty of people need to know about Jesus. Mountain View, Eden Rock, everywhere we live. Fern Forest, Fern Acres, Hawaiian Acres, Aloha Estates, everywhere you can think of. Glenwood, everywhere you can think of is everywhere in the world. And tell the good news to everyone. And that's not going to happen unless we make a plan. If we don't plan, then we're going to be sitting here again next year. 1 year would have gone by. Still, no good news being shared because we didn't plan. Now, if that happens next year, I don't want it to be that we were not reminded, because the Lord is reminding us right now. Plan to share the good news. And so right now, you can be praying about that. That's one of the ways where you can start to plan. You can start to, if you don't know where to start, you can start to serve in some place. That will facilitate your and help your planning. You can give your congregation. This congregation has been extremely generous. Continue that, because that's going to help in that whole process. You can start to invite. You don't have to wait for Christmas. You can start to invite right now. You can listen. You can show up. Like, I cannot tell you what a blessing it is that you show up. You who are here in person and you are who are here on Zoom. Sometimes, especially since we're in person, I don't get to see all the people that are tuning in on Zoom. When we did Zoom only, I could see the screen and I could see everybody's picture. But now that we do in person, I very rarely get to see it, but I got to see it today. What a blessing. If you show up, that's part of planning too. I mean, you had to, you know, you could have just stayed in bed, but people rolled out of bed. People turned on their computer. People put in the link and everything like that. That's all part of the process. But the bottom line is, just like you plan to be here, either in person or on Zoom, you have to plan to share the good news. The message is, it's time to share the good news. I don't know if anybody watches mixed martial arts, MMA, sometimes can be controversial. You bring that subject up in church. If it's controversial, people don't like mixed martial arts, then I'm going to say, I heard this from Jason. He watches mixed martial arts. I don't watch mixed martial arts. He watches. But if it's all right, then I'll confess. Oh, I watch mixed martial arts too. But there's a guy that says at the beginning of the match in one of these promotions, ladies and gentlemen, before the match is about to start, ladies and gentlemen, it's time. And I tell you, it's time to do what? To share the good news of Christ. Now, here's the last thing, the fourth thing. You would know this too. I must trust God. So let's admit it. Sometimes it can get frustrating in sharing the good news. And I hope I'm not alone in that. If I am, I'm going to feel really terrible. Because sometimes sharing the good news for me goes splendidly, fantastic. Other times, not so fantastic. Like people will show me the door, you know, and I just think I better get out of here quick because I think there's a foot coming behind me just in the next few moments. It doesn't go exactly like I would like. So you try to share the good news with somebody and for whatever reason, they don't want to hear it. So you start saying the good news. Hey, let me talk to you about this. Shh. It's Jesus. I want to. Shh. So you never get any momentum to get started. You never even get before they shut you down. Now, maybe you've experienced that too. They just, for whatever reason, it's not going to happen. It's as uncomfortable as all get out because you just don't know what to do and you want to give up. And when you want to give up, then remember Romans, Jason Morton's favorite book, but now in chapter 8 and in verse 25. But if we must keep trusting God for something that hasn't happened yet, it teaches us to wait patiently and confidently. That is for a forewarning for us that sometimes it may not turn out exactly as we would like. We want to share the good news, but it's not going well. And okay, we're on the edge of getting discouraged or disappointed. We want to quit. The word of the Lord says, but if we have to keep trusting God because it didn't turn out like we wanted for something that hasn't happened yet, like I know my relative is going to, you know, accept Christ someday, but it hasn't happened yet. The Bible says here, Romans 8:25, it teaches us to wait patiently and confidently. Confidently meaning it's going to happen, not in this time, but at the proper time, at its perfect time, it will occur. That means don't give up. Don't give up. It means hang in there. It means wait, as this passage said, patiently and confidently. Keep trusting and keep telling. So, okay, it didn't work out with this particular person. Keep telling another person. keep trusting the Lord. Keep moving forward. Remember, my part and God's part, because that's how it really breaks down. You read the scripture, there's God's part and my part. And when it comes to this whole topic of the good news, it's the same as we see all through scripture. God's got a part and we have a part. Now, let me remind you, my part, our part, is to tell somebody. You can fill it in that way. Tell somebody, tell someone. That's my part. Notice I said when I gave you those notes, it says tell, not sell. Everybody please say it with me. Tell, not sell. Ready to go? Tell, not sell. Okay? Because we're not selling anything. Sometimes when we're speaking to people, they think we're selling. We're not selling anything. All I'm doing is telling you. In fact, I'm not selling it. What I'm telling you is what has happened with a satisfied customer. So if the good news of Christ is a product, I've received that product and I am a satisfied customer. That's what I'm telling you. I'm not selling it to you. If you don't want it, then don't get it. I'm just saying I bought it. I embraced it. Christ lives in my heart. I abide in him and he abides in me. And I'm totally satisfied. 100,000%. That's what I'm telling. And that's what I'm just trying to share with you. I'm not trying to sell it to you. So please remind yourself, we are telling. We are not selling. That's our part. God didn't tell us to be salesmen. He just said, tell the good news. So that's what we're going to do. That's my part. Now, God's got a part too. And God's part, you can fill this in, is to change lives. Just like it happened with us, then it happens with other people. You sit here, as many of you who have received Christ, you sit here today different than you used to be. You know it. And the people around you know it too. Your spouse knows it. Your friends know it. Your children know it. Your grandchildren know it. Your siblings know it. Everybody knows it, that you are different because of the good news of Christ. That your life got changed because that's what God does. Only God does that. We sing a song around here that says exactly that. Only a God like you, only God can do it. So as you tell, then you embrace. This book very seldom, I think for me, I very seldom refer to the book of Philemon, but I am referring to it now in chapter 1. As you tell, as you embrace the good news of Christ, as you're sharing the good news, you embrace Philemon chapter 1, where we read in verse number 6, I pray that as you share your faith with others, it will grip their lives too, oh, like vice grips, as they see the wealth of good things in you that come from Christ Jesus. Everybody please say amen. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for allowing us to gather this morning. We thank you, Lord, for allowing us to dig into this word this morning. We are grateful, Lord, for all of the passages you have brought to our minds and to our hearts. We pray, Lord, that you would help us to share the good news, that it is always the time to share the good news, Lord. Help us to do all of the things that we spoke about this morning. Lord, unless I miss my guess, you have already put some names on our hearts, people that we wanted to share the good news with, but we haven't so far been able to do it or do it very successfully. Help us, Lord, with that, we pray in Jesus' name, that Christmas 2021 was going to be a fantastic celebration when many of the people that we know come to Christ. Come because of that good news being shared. We are thankful for that, Lord. We pray that you continue to bathe us with your presence, Lord. We pray it in Jesus Christ's name. Congregation, if there's anybody either on Zoom, or here in person. We are doing this live. Anybody not who has not had the opportunity to make a commitment to Christ, this is addressed to you right now. If you don't have a relationship with Christ, open your heart. We strongly encourage that, as strongly as anybody can. Open your heart to Christ. Let him come in. All you have to do is believe, trust in him, open your heart, confess that he is the Lord, that he's going to be the Lord of your life, and he's going to come in. That's it for now. You will grow together. Your relationship will get better and better and better. You'll speak to him. He'll listen. He'll speak to you. You'll listen. The Bible says that he's going to be close to you, a very close companion to you. And he's going to walk with you through every circumstance of life. If that's for you, open your heart this morning. It really is that simple. He paid the price for your sins once and for all. Pray this prayer in your heart. You can pray it silently. I'll pray it aloud. If you're here in person or on Zoom, you can pray it silently. I'll pray it aloud. Just say to the Lord, Heavenly Father, I'm a sinner. Do that confession before him. I've done lots of things, and I've not asked you to be involved in it. In fact, sometimes I've run away from having you involved. I want to change that now. That's part of your confession. This morning, I recognize you as my forgiver, and I want to follow you as my Lord. Come into my life. That's your invitation to the Lord. Come into my life, and as best as I know how, for as long as I know how, I will follow you. And then you can have a declaration to him, to yourself, to other people that may be around you. So now I say, so I can hear me and you can hear me. So my neighbors can hear me. So the devil can hear me. Jesus Christ is my Lord. I will follow him and him alone. Thank you, Jesus, for loving me first. That's all it takes. Now, if you've done that, tell somebody that you are enjoying now the relationship with Christ and you are well on your way. Don't keep it to yourself. Share it with somebody. This great news that you now have received salvation. You're now assured of a place with the Lord in heaven for all time. And his constant companionship and direction, blessing, revelation, rejuvenation here as you live life on this earth. Tell somebody. Lord, we pray that you would continue to watch over us and keep us safe. We ask, Lord, that you would put a hedge of protection. Sometimes during the New Year's Eve season, accidents on the road happen, accidents with fireworks happen, and all kinds of different things. Lord, we pray your protection in Jesus' name, that you would keep us safe. We ask, Lord, that as far as health issues are concerned, we thank you for the healing that has gone on so far. We thank you, Lord, for the healing that is to come. And we thank you, Lord, that you continue to protect us, this congregation, and our immediate families and friends. We pray, Lord, that you keep us safe from COVID-19, that virus. We thank you, Lord, in advance for all that you are, all that you're going to do. We thank you, Lord, that we can celebrate you today. We love you, Lord. We thank you and pray in Jesus Christ's holy name. Congregation, please help me close by saying amen and amen. We're going to sing a song now. Be bold, be strong. The Lord thy God is with you. If you're in the room and you want to stay and sing, please feel free. If you're ready to go home, we want to say thanks again for coming. All of you on Zoom, God bless you. Happy New Year. Don't forget Jason's link on Thursday, New Year's Eve, 5 o'clock. We're all going to pray, just like we had a prayer meeting just a month or two ago. We'll have a prayer meeting again. God bless you, everybody. Have a great day. Okay.
Be bold, be strong. The Lord thy God is with thee.
you ready to take a stand? Are you ready to take a stand? Are you ready to take his land for the Lord? Be bold, be strong. The Lord thy God is with thee. Be bold, be strong. The Lord thy God is with thee. Do not be afraid. Do not be dismayed. Walk in faith and victory. Walk in faith and victory. Walk in faith and victory. For the Lord thy God is with thee.
For the Lord.
For the Lord thy God is with thee. For the Lord thy God is with thee.
God bless you, everybody. Happy New Year.